Chemotherapy is a group of drugs that we give to fight the cancer, and it primarily works by stopping growth of the cancer cells out or killing them off within the cell cycle.
Unfortunately, it can also affect normal cells, and when it affects those normal cells, you can develop some side effects.
There are many, many different types of chemotherapy depending on what type of cancer you have, what stage of cancer you have, and what type of cell the cancer is.
Chemotherapy can be given on its own. Sometimes it's a combination of drugs. Sometimes we give it in combination with immunotherapy, which is a different set of drugs, or with targeted therapies.
The type of chemotherapy that you'll have will be determined by your team, and they're the ones who will decide how long you'll have it for.
Chemotherapy comes in a number of different forms. It can be oral, which means it can be tablet form, or it can be intravenous. And by that, what I mean is that it goes directly into a vein. Or your team may advise you to have something called a PICC line, which is a semi-permanent line that will stay in for the duration of your chemotherapy. Or there may be a portacath, and a portacath is a device which sits in the chest and communicates directly with one of the larger vessels of the body.
Chemotherapy can be given over a number of hours. It can sometimes be given as a bolus injection, so that's over a few minutes. Sometimes treatment needs to be delivered over more than 24 hours, and you will go home with your infusion pump, and when the pump finishes, you come back to the unit to have it disconnected.
So at your oncology appointment, you'll meet an oncologist as well as a clinical nurse specialist. And they're the point of contact for you to discuss any concerns that you have or any questions that you have regarding your treatment.
Any extra clarification that you need, when you're supposed to come for chemo, what you need to do, or what side effects that you might expect, so we can go through things.
We'll discuss the practicalities of treatment. You'll be given some information on the specific chemotherapy drugs that you'll be given, and we'll go through some side effects. And when you're comfortable, then you can sign the consent form. Sometimes that is in the first visit. Sometimes you need some time to discuss the treatment plan with your friends or family, or think about the treatment yourself. And we can take consent over the telephone or video, as well as face to face.
Before every chemotherapy is delivered, you will need to have a COVID swab a couple of days beforehand, as well as blood tests. And this is important to know that your blood count is acceptable and that you will tolerate the chemotherapy. So chemotherapy is usually given as an intravenous fusion in a specialised unit called the chemotherapy unit. And it's given by trained specialist nurses who are very experienced in the delivery of chemotherapy and their side effects.
So once you come in, we sit you in a chair. Make sure that you're comfortable. If you are going to have a cannula, then I will get the cannula ready. A cannula is a needle that is put into your vein. Once it's in, I'll take the needle out. Then there'll be a plastic tube sitting in the vein. So this is how the chemotherapy is delivered. And then you have anti-sickness to prevent you being sick. And we wait for half an hour to 45 minutes for the anti-sickness to start working, and then the treatment will begin. We will make you feel comfortable and then just keep monitoring you.
Mostly you don't feel anything or very little. If you do notice any side effects, there will be lots of staff around, there'll be nurses, and then they can respond to you appropriately.
Sometimes it's about slowing the rate of infusion. If you're feeling unwell, they may stop it and monitor you for a little while, or they may give you some supportive medications to make sure that you're comfortable and tolerating the infusion.
Once your chemotherapy is finished, the nurse will give you your chemotherapy diary with all the chemotherapies that they've given you, and your next appointment will be also written in there.
There's a section where we want you to write down your side effects. It's very important. It really helps us so that we know how your treatment is getting along.
You will be given medication to take home with you. And those medications are given, they're supportive medications, to help you tolerate the treatment.
These medications are tailored to the particular chemotherapy drugs that you have been given, and mostly will include some anti-sickness medications, as well as steroids which can help with sickness.
The nurse will explain every individual item that they'll be giving you to take home. So whether you're sick or not, it's advisable that you take the tablets just for the first few days after your treatment, just to help prevent the sickness. If those tablets that we've given to you, they're not working, they can change your medications to something else that works better for you.
And also, we may give you some injections to help boost your white cells to reduce the risk of any infection. These are injections that you can administer yourself just under the surface of the skin.
If you do need to administer injections at home, the nurses on the unit will make sure that you feel comfortable giving those injections. Before you go, after your period of observation and the nurse is happy for you to leave, you will be given a red alert card that you must keep on you with the emergency contact numbers, which includes the 24/7 hotline to call if you need advice out of hours or even during the day. We do encourage you to ask somebody, at least if it's your first treatment, to come and pick you up rather than drive home yourself.
Even when you're home and you finished your treatment, we are always here. You can either contact your team or you can always contact the acute oncology team through the 24-hour hotline number.
As well as your clinical team, there are other people within the hospital who also want to hear how you're getting on with your treatment. You'll remember having met your clinical nurse specialist at the beginning of your cancer journey, and most likely within your hospital there will be a cancer support centre. You'll find somebody like me who's always here to listen to what you're going through and may be able to help you by offering some of those handy hints and tips that only people who have been through the kind of treatment you're having before you are able to share. We can give you up-to-date information about how to cope with what's going on, and we can also help put you in touch with patients who have been through what you're going through.